Could you explain what the brain's positioning system is?
Yeah, the brain's positioning system is a part of the brain that helps us find our way, navigate, as we say. So that consists of some brain areas. They're called entorhinal cortex, hippocampus. And those brain areas contain certain cells that are important for mapping our own position in space. So these are called place cells in the hippocampus, grid cells in the entorhinal cortex, and a number of other cells that all seem to be elements in a system that helps us map our location in space.
And how were you able to identify the brain's positioning system?
Well, that has a long history. So the work started long before my time. A major event was John O'Keefe's discovery of place cells in 1971. Place cells are cells that are active only when rats, and now we know also humans, are present in a certain location in space. And then many years later, when in 2005, we found that this system contains cells that we call grid cells. So those are cells that operate much like a coordinate system. They are active at, each cell is active at many locations, and those locations form a lattice or a grid that covers the entire environment. And in addition, there are also other types of cells that signal direction, distance from boundaries and objects, and so on. It's a long series of discoveries that has taken place over a period of more than 50 years. And it started out probably somewhat by coincidence, because the campus where the place cells were found was mostly known for a role in memory. But then these cells are so striking that when O'Keefe found them, obviously that was the beginning of many decades of work that now, I can say, has identified a brain system that is quite active in mapping our position in space.
And what are some of the most exciting implications of your research there?
What I'm most excited about nowadays is actually not the particular types of cells themselves. So this was quite exciting at the time, because there aren't many other systems in the cortex of the brain that have so many cells with so dedicated functions or properties. If we are to understand navigation and mapping of our own position, we also need to understand how these cells work together. And brain cells never do things alone. They work in circuits of thousands or 10,000s of cells that are intermingled and spread out, and it's quite difficult. And up until now, it was very, very hard to say much about how they worked, because we didn't have access to all this data from so many cells at the same time. But now we have, so there are new techniques that allow us to record from many thousands of cells at the same time while a mouse or a rat is performing behavioral tasks. And we have also developed a new type of microscope that allows us to look at the activity of thousands of cells during performance of behavior. So these are new times where we actually can study brain operations and the navigation system in networks and circuits rather than individual cells. And that excites me quite a lot.